was reading a story about animals, and I read about this giant Galapagos tortoise named Lonesome George, and coincidentally, Lonesome George is the last of his subspecies of Galapagos tortoise. He's the last remaining tortoise of his kind. The Darwin Foundation is scouring the globe searching for a suitable mate for Lonesome George. They basically line up tortoises, tortoise women, for him. Okay, no other tortoise in the world gets this kind of treatment. Here's Lonesome George. God knows how old he is. Last of his kind. They're parading the tortoise pussy right in front of him, and he goes, no, with his long-ass neck. No. No, thank you. Lonesome George, let me be completely honest with you right now. I don't know what you're doing. You're the last of your kind. I don't know how you could just stare at the tortoise pussy and take a whiff of that and go, no. Come on, man. I mean, you're a tortoise. I don't want to judge, but what is your day like? You wake up, you go walk around, you eat some leaves, you take a shit, you go to sleep. That's it. Don't you think maybe something else would make your life a little bit more interesting? I mean, you got no one else around you. What, are you having conversations with the tortoise whores that they bring to you? These are not well-versed tortoise women who are learned and educated and can engage in long, eloquent conversations with you. I need to tap them on the shell and say, excuse me, sir. Yeah, you're the last of what you are. We're going to give you a chance to make some more of you. You know, it's not rocket science. You take your tortoise dick and you put it in the tortoise vagina, and you make tortoise pudding, and it goes inside the tortoise lady, and it creates a tortoise egg of some sort. I actually don't know how it works, but it can't be too complicated. Here's what I don't understand. If you so much care about him getting, making more tortoise babies, why don't you just jack him off? Sneak up behind him with a little Dixie cup and massage until whoopsies, then take the Dixie cup over to a tortoise lady. Dip some sort of a Twizzler in the tortoise goop, and then put it in the tortoise lady, and the tortoise lady's gonna go, and you got more tortoises. I mean, am I missing something? Is this needed to be the actual act so that we humans can surround this and watch and take pictures while giggling? This is a tortoise, last of his kind, and they're trying to get him to fuck other tortoises to make him more tortoises. Doesn't sound too bad, but let's think, what if you were this tortoise? What if aliens came to Earth, found you as the last surviving human, and then brought gorillas of some sort, like half human, half gorillas, because this is not tortoises of his species, okay? He is the last of his species! So that's like aliens taking gorilla women and saying, you know what? Get it on! Excuse me, I ain't doing Coco over there. That ain't happening. Okay? Why you want me to do that, it's clearly going to be disturbing from start till end, and then some, so what are we doing here? I don't care. Okay, yeah, that one's got bigger titties, but I don't, you know, again, I'm not in the market. I'll die alone. I am not fucking a baboon. And you got to imagine, this is a giant tortoise. He figures he's going to live another 200 years or something like that, maybe even longer, because tortoises don't experience the same risks as humans. They don't die in horrible accidents. They don't die, ever get hit by cars or fall off a motorcycle or get trapped in a Ferris wheel and starve to death. That kind of thing doesn't happen to tortoises. All they do is walk around. They have no real natural predators that I know of. So maybe this guy's just waiting around. He figures, hey, they're going to keep bringing me tortoise whores. I'm going to wait till the tortoise pussy is right, and then I'm going to jump on it. Jesus!